Alright, we've reached our final round here at Le Mans. This is a really long lap, so there's a lot of places where you can find time, and lots of it. Turn 1 is flat, but you want to get to the left a little bit and set yourself up to be on the right side of the track for the chicane. For the chicane, you want to brake at the first board on the right, and you want to try to be straight under braking or else the rear end's going to come around. You can take pretty big cuts on the inside of both these corners, but obviously try to focus on the exit. Now coming out of here, you want to try to keep right to set yourself up for this chicane. I would try to brake just before the service road on the right, or use the tire marks in the ground as a braking point. Depending on your gearing, you want to take this in third, and you again want to treat it like a chicane, focusing on the exit. Now for Tête Rouge, which for some reason is a blind corner on this mod, you want to brake around the blue paint on the right, and just follow the tire marks over the crest. Now for the first part of the Mulsanne straight, here it's very important to make sure you have the gearing correct. You do need to take into consideration that slipstream can drastically up your top speed, so make sure you account for that in the final drive. It can feel like a really long time before you get to the braking boards, but you need to make sure you spot the first one because it's hard to read the numbers. For this first chicane, I'm braking just in between the 200 and the 100, or around the tire marks in the rear. I hold third here on the entry and downshift to second for the second leg. This is to focus on the exit and also because the curbs are very deadly on this first chicane. One other thing to remember with Le Mans is this is a very high speed track with a long straight, but it's important to remember that there are a lot of corners on this track where having aero will benefit you. With that being said, you can always be consistent in a straight line, so sometimes running lower aero is better. As I said, everything's a compromise and this will make you less consistent in the corners, but it may fit your driving style. And after enough rambling on the straight, we're coming up to the braking markers. You want to be braking just before the 100 or around the tire marks again. I did come in a little too hot to this corner and had to do a bit more braking for the second leg, and this compromised my exit a bit. This corner can be really deceptive, but you want to brake just before the curbing on the right, or again, around the tire marks. It's important to not cut this corner too much, as the curbing is very deadly. I did take too much speed here at the apex, which caused a pretty slow exit. Now in the run down to Indianapolis is another part where running low aero and longer gears will give you a benefit. It is important to not get distracted while on the straight, because it does curve a little bit, and the curbs on the inside are very deadly. Now coming up into Indianapolis is another corner you take similar to the first complex. The rear end of the car is going to get very unstable under braking, so it's important to try to get the car straight before you apply the brakes. So here, I'm lightly braking just before the corner and coming down a gear. Then I try to get straightened out and then hard on the brakes down to second. Then for Arnage, this corner is very simple. You're just braking at the curbing on the left and taking a nice square line. Now we're onto the last long straight, and this is the last spot you're going to get any benefit from running lower aero. It's very likely that any time that you gain from running lower aero is going to go away very easily in the Porsche curves. To set yourself up for this one, you want to get pretty far to the left side of the track. Easy braking just after the 100, you do want to come down to 4th, but do that slowly to not unsettle the car. Now you can get on throttle, and you should be able to take both of the left-handers flat. However, I did lift on this lap because I turned in a bit too late. Now for these last two corners, you want to treat this like a chicane, where you want to keep the inside through this right-hander to set yourself up for a good exit out of the left-hander. Just a lift required here, but you want to make sure you keep it in on the exit, because that's going to result in an invalid lap or a liftoff penalty. Now for the last two chicanes, this is where it can all fall apart very easily. Plan to brake about halfway through the pit lane on the right. I'm down to third. It's very sketchy, but you can actually jump both of these curbs on the inside. Then try to get back to the right side and try to take these last two corners with as much speed as you can. Alright, and if you made it through that, give yourself a pat on the back because that was nearly a 4-minute lap. With that being said, that wraps up the Porsche series, but we're going to be back again next week and we're going to be racing in the Praga. It should make for an interesting series. You can find the proposed track list in the description, but that's all I got for you. Thanks for watching this week and we'll see you next week in the Praga.